go. This is a fun little game I had an enjoyable time doing. There's only two things in this game I don't like. For like being a really small project that's also a free-to-play game, there's just two things that bother me. Menus are really buggy, so that's unfortunate. But that's at least able to be dealt with for the most part. Because there's not a lot of reason to go to the menus. The actual worst part is just the fact that the tutorial might as well be the hardest part of the game. And that's not a joke. And that can be seen in a moment. This right here, this stinking book stack, is the only thing in the game that gives me any real issues. It is very, very obnoxious. Like, there's a few ways you can start getting up it, but that last book especially, there's not much you can do other than pray. And that's an example of a more consistent way to get up compared to the fastest way. I'm going to be doing a lot of consistent compared fast. But there is no consistent or fast way to do this. This is just a get lucky that the book lets you up. There we go. Woo! Thank the Lord. Like, that is my least favorite part of the game. Right there. From this point on, it'll be a lot better. I think that's the fastest I've ever gotten on there, too. Like, that was really nice. But yeah, I'm not going to go for pure speed. I'm going to be doing a lot of consistent things, and if things just go slightly poorly, I'll just let it go. I'm not looking to be super optimized and be insane. It's just for fun. Bow wow wow. Also, this gives people time to make fun of me for realizing that I am a slow strategy player. Not this quick movement person. But that's fine. The second best upgrade in the game. Theoretically, the third one might be the best, but I think it only works because this exists in the first place. Oops, I had accidentally jumped up off. Jumping off there is not really good for speed. I'll go up this way. It'll be faster to go this way, I think. That's fine. We'll lose some time, but it's fine. So I know there's multiple wings in the game. I can't really tell you exactly how many wings there are. I would assume four, but I've only ever been to two. We're going to try to see if we can go fast enough to get this in the first cycle. Otherwise, we'll have to wait a little bit, but oh well. Yeah, we missed the first cycle, but that's fine. There'll be some... There's going to be an interesting thing I do with the glider here, because the movement, the time it has, you'll notice on the bottom, it doesn't reset on everything. So normally when you get grounded, it will reset how long you have to glide. But for example, I'm not going to glide right here, because for some reason this shelf part here doesn't reset it. And I want the glider part movement so I can skip this area. Because I do not want to be doing all of this. There we go. It feels like certain parts of that shelf might reset it, but that initial area, I'm pretty sure doesn't. Every time I've tried, it doesn't. So I've just given up on that. That's the first time we're going to the archives. We'll be coming... There we go. We'll be coming back one more time, and then we're done with the archives for the rest of the game. And this is the area that made me want to actually speedrun it.
Go ahead and take a look around.
Mainly because I feel like... Or I know I skipped a lot of what I'm supposed to do. We'll have to turn off the fan first. I like the little things we can do with this character. Their design's pretty neat too, so it's nice. These purple books are probably the best ones because they're always consistent. They're super consistent. There's stuff on the right side, but we basically don't go to the right side at all this game. Like, all the stuff on the right side is almost ignorable on the first two floors. The third floor will be over there, but the first two floors will basically ignore the right side of this area. But yeah, there's some fun things you can do. It's interesting. And the purple books are super consistent, so that's nice. Anyone who actually wants to play to try to, like, do fast, I did it. Usually I don't actually get up there the first time I try. The chair makes it easier. I also did this consistently. You can actually run into it from the side and not go around, and you can still get up there. But I prefer that more consistent, and you can just jump across there. You're supposed to turn it off, and you're also supposed to use another way to get up here, but... Let's make it easy. But sometimes that bugs out a little bit, but it's fine. So we're going to come this way. We're pretty much ignoring this whole floor. We're not going to do a darn thing on this floor. We're just going to come up here and do the telescope. Okay. Now comes the next only other really obnoxious part. And it's not so much because this part's hard. I'm just bad. Nice enough that they give us a little jump back up here so we don't have to keep going back around and everything, but... And this part, as I said, isn't technically hard, but I'm just bad. I'm going to make sure that our movement is reset. Also, when you hit to glide, you'll always move forward. You can't stop. There we go. We got that first movement. I normally prefer to go right side next, but we're already over here. So I think we'll just go this way. And just pray that I don't screw it up. I screwed it up. It's fine, though. They give us the jump to make it faster. I should have just jumped down this way and gone up back through the book so I could save some time and just go up the right side. But it's fine. You lose a good chunk of time, but it's fine. Funny enough, the first time I went through here, this was the hardest one for me to find. I always forget that I can just crouch and go places. Let me out! Let me make sure gliding is reset. We'll hold casting it for a little bit so we get farther distance. And we'll skip the entire puzzle that we're supposed to do there. Now there's... Yep. The last page is over here. I tried to go go for it right away a moment ago. I should have saved it. We would have already been done with this area if I had. But it's fine. It's in this little area that seems like it's supposed to be a maze, but... Oops, I accidentally canceled my glide, but it's fine. We'll just come back through here. This area is basically complete now. We just gotta go through the book. And then we'll get the actual best upgrade, power-up. And hopefully it'll be really easy to tell why it's the best. So sad. That says, I feel like we're missing a big chunk of the story at this point. Or, not a big chunk of the story. We're going to be missing a big chunk of the story after this point. Because it wants us to go into the West Wing. And we never are going to. I also don't know if this game has a South Wing. If it does, I've never even seen it. It probably does, and I just skipped it this whole time. But here's the... Here we go. The double jump is extremely, extremely useful. I take it over the glide, but both of them together is what makes a lot of it fun. The movement in this game is actually a lot of fun. I feel like if they ever decided to make a more polished, like, updated version of this game that was longer and other stuff, I'd love it. A lot of the movement in this game is really fun. Though I'm wondering if the dark area I go to at the end of the game is actually the South Wing, and I just never realized it was South Wing. Because we don't come back through here. I just go there. So, the West Wing that it wants us to go to is to our right. We're going to come this way instead. As a mechanic with the jumping, the frog, a lot of times I will save my glide until after jumping a little bit so I can get farther ranges. Don't wow wow wow. So this is us going into the West Wing, or East Wing. We're pretty much halfway done now. This area is interesting because we have to activate four valves to make it through. But we have to always activate the first two in order. If we don't activate the first two in order, it bugs out. The second one, for the most part, bugs out a little bit. And it will not let you progress. So even though you can get the fourth one first, which is right up there on the right side, we'll end up getting it last because we basically have to if we don't want the valves messing up and bugging out. It's a little bit of... obnoxious that way, we can't optimize it that way, but it's fine otherwise. We'd end up going everywhere anyways, it just ends up taking a little bit longer than it would have otherwise, so I'm not upset over it. Okay. There we go. Sometimes these will be a little bit annoying, but for the most part it's not too bad. And we can't go up the right side because it's raining. Okay. I've had that happen a few times to me as well. I can't tell you exactly what causes it, but it almost always happens in the same areas. That time, me dying was my own fault. That should not have happened. of these time wastes that happens is my fault. Because, yeah, the first drop was the game just screwed me over, which is unfortunate. But once again, it's like a school project. It's not like you should expect it to... It's free to play. So you shouldn't be expecting perfection or anything. It's fun for what it is, I'll say. And we want to go up over there instead of walking straight through and climbing because it skips a cutscene. And now normally if we do that out of order and don't get that second, this place would be blocked off and it'll try to keep you from passing here. You can actually still climb up on the right side so you can get through. You can also climb on top of that, but I find it faster to actually just go straight up this way to the book compared to climbing up. So there's a lot of things we can do, but you don't have to. There's no reason to do the extra effort when we can just do it this way. This is the one that I feel like has the hardest time actually getting the first time compared to all of them. Most of the valves are fine. That's the hardest one I feel like to get the first time. Wee 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 wee. But it's fine. Now, I'd like to go that way to get out and just go straight to the next part, but we do have to actually come this way so we can get the last valve. So if we went the other valve first, we would have just jumped out that way down. And unfortunately, we're going to hit a cutscene here that we can't skip. And if we were able to go up the right side first without any issues, we could have just skipped that entire cutscene. You don't have to worry too much about that jump. It's not as tight as it might look, because the shelf below will also catch you. And we do have to avoid all the water that falls down from the ceiling, because if that catches you, it'll drop us and we'll just die. I could have jumped up on the right side there, and I should have, because it saves time. And it allows us to... This cutscene will still play if we go on that side, but we can basically jump into a good position for it if I went up the right side instead of doing that. And we would have landed in the chair. So if you do go up the right side to save a little bit of time, land in the chair, because you cannot grab the... You cannot grab the switch during a cutscene. And it'll always play, so... Well, that's interesting. I've never, like, not made that. I guess I'm playing a little bit riskier than I normally do, too. I don't know. Or less risky. Don't know. Depends on the situation. Usually it's very easy to do this. And this is the path we would have taken to go back to the start if we got this one first. We'll just end up using it to get back to the start for the most part. Oh, I didn't make it! What? Oh, no! That's a first. That's a little unfortunate. Because I wanted to land here and then jump up here. We'll catch this ledge. There's also a bunch of these pages, but we don't care. And I'm making quite a few mistakes now, but it'll be fine. And this is the path we would have taken. And we would have gone up the full right side there. And pretty much skipped all the water bouncing and other stuff. But now we'll just come down here. And after this, we'll be unlocking the upgrade that basically breaks the rest of the game. It's a lot of fun to use, at least, but it does kind of break the game a bit. I guess this isn't the south wing, because I was mentioning earlier, it's still the west wing. Okay. I mentioned earlier, I wonder if the last area I didn't think was south wing, but no, it's still west wing, you just said it there. I just never paid attention. Never thought about actually paying attention. But yeah, we got the little corrupted enemies now. They're not going to be too much of a problem as long as I don't massively screw up like I do half the time. But it'll be fine. We got this last book to read. So this is our very last book we'll read. Here's the lantern. It's a required, like, we can't beat the game without it, so we can't skip it. But even if we could, we wouldn't want to, because of what it lets us do. Now we're just going to run past them. Okay, I don't know what I hit. Is there something there that I never noticed? Strange. I guess there's something there that I just didn't notice. I've always just run past it, though. Because we can basically just... What in the world? Something's wrong. It feels like something's very wrong. Because I've never had an issue there. Just ducking under. Because we can just do this. Okay, I guess we're gonna light the thing. This is weird. I've played through this part a few times already. And this is the very first time it's giving me this issue, where I can't just skip it. It seems weird to me. Ugh. Okay, this camera's a little obnoxious, but that's kind of because we're not doing what we're supposed to. Oh no, this is gonna be really bad because I actually don't know how to do this part. Oh no, I don't know what I'm supposed to do. It's never made me do this before. I've never had to play this part correctly. What am I supposed to do? Oh no. There's stuff back here, so maybe something back here. Oh, there's a switch. Like, I don't know what's going on. Switch there that does something. Oh, I see. So weird, though. I've never once have had to do that. Every other time I've just been able to, like, immediately duck under there. So it's really weird that it made me have to do all that for it. If I knew what I was supposed to actually do, I could have probably done that faster. But oh well. It's fine. I'm gonna jump down there so we can reset before the next part. Now we do, because I thought this was like the one of the only lights we had to light right there, but apparently we had to do that one. We'll just duck under there instead of going the other way. We'll do that to reset. Oh, I should mention with lantern gliding, we are basically going to have to switch back into the plane
Because the plane will not reset if we land on Lantern. But the Lantern lets us glide for a while. So I'll always try to switch back there. Now we're going to walk under here instead of going around the top path. I don't know if we're supposed to go through the top path, but I prefer not to, so we're not going to. Basically just going to the end here and then we're done. And now we're gonna do the boss. The boss requires to light three of the lanterns, and then when we light them, we win. This is how I feel like the lantern is not supposed to interact this way. Because it feels like a lot of what we can do here is because we can do stuff with the lantern we're not supposed to. Like, it feels like the lantern isn't supposed to interact with the way it does, with being able to fly. Maybe it was always supposed to fly, but it just feels like it's not supposed to. Because it pretty much lets you just go across the entire map. And if we do end up losing our life here, it's fine. It doesn't really have any consequence. Except for, like, moving where you are. And that's fine. We want to drop here, so it gives us a reset point in case we die. Time. Ooh, I accidentally hit reset instead of stop on the timer. What a shame. I can just look at what it was when I was supposed to hit it, but oh well. Well, that's Paige Turner. It's an enjoyable game. I had fun with it. It's not too terribly long, but I feel like I skipped half the game as well, so I'm not sure about everything. And once again, it's like a small school project some people made. I had no part in it, so I don't know anything I can really say about behind the scenes or anything, or if anybody plans to pick stuff back up or whatever. But I enjoyed it. I had fun. It's free in case anyone wants to play it. And I'm sure there's a lot of ways to heavily optimize and do a lot of things I did better. But I'm just going to let the credits roll before I do anything. But yeah. I'm trying to think if there's anything else to mention that I enjoyed or liked, or things about it that was neat. Because I enjoyed the movement. The movement was fun. The character's animation's fun. I didn't show off any idle animations, but some of the idle was fun. Man. I don't know the full character stories because I kind of skipped through all that. Oh yeah, the music that they used, I don't know if anybody made it or if it's royalty free or any of that, because once again, school project, I don't know. But it was nice, it was relaxing. The music was nice. I had nothing against that at all. Once again, the only big problems with this is it is a little buggy in some places. That's expected from what it is. It's not supposed to be some big project or anything. The really only annoying things, once again, the beginning books can be really annoying to get up, and menus. The pause menu sometimes bugs out and you can't do anything with it, so you have to restart the whole game. And the starting menu,
use your keyboard. If you try to use your mouse and you don't actually click on the right kind of thing right away, it'll screw up a bit. But other than that, a lot of these problems are probably Unity. Gosh dang it, Unity. But yeah, I had fun. But now for the best part. That's not what we're talking about, by the way. There it is. The best part. Thanks for playing.